reaches of space, like a pinpoint at infinity, there once was a tiny blue star. Spanning the billions of miles that separated this star from the Earth, we discover that it was in reality a planet like our own. This was the ill-fated planet Krypton, which revolved about the brilliant sun of its own solar system, while satellites like ringed moons in turn revolved about it. Krypton was a rugged planet, laced with jagged mountain chains, rich in strange minerals unknown to Earth. And on a wide plateau lay the capital of Krypton, the nerve center of a civilization that was far advanced, for it boasted a race of super men and women. Among the leaders was Jor-El, the foremost man of science. Jor-El had concluded that Krypton was being inexorably drawn toward its sun and would one day explode like a giant bubble and disintegrate. Jor-El's wife, Lara, inspired him in his feverish race to construct a trial spaceship. If successful, he planned to build a mammoth fleet to carry the inhabitants of the doomed planet to safety on Earth. Now, giant subterranean pockets of gas exploded, touching off long sealed volcanoes. Plumes of fire lit the sky. Molten lava scarred Krypton's surface. The fears of Jor-El and Lara were intensified by their concern for the safety of their infant son. To Jor-El, the tremors and shocks, which were now more frequent and violent, were an indication that the cataclysmic day was not far off. Yielding to Jor-El's urgent demands, Rozan, leader of the council, summoned his colleagues in emergency session.
Members of the council, we're all well aware of the phenomena that Krypton's been experiencing the past few weeks.
Recently, a great tidal wave threatened to engulf our capital. Now, quakes and eruptions of mysterious origin are occurring with increasing frequency.
Our distinguished scientist, Jor-El, has brought me an alarming report. I refer him to you.
Gentlemen, I cannot stress enough the urgency of the task before us. Krypton is doomed. Even as we discuss this holocaust, our days, perhaps even our hours, are numbered. I urge you to heed my warning.
I demand that Jor-El explain his reason for uttering this fantastic prophecy.
Jor-El is trying to frighten us. Jor-El, your predictions are nonsense, an insult to this distinguished body.
We're waiting, Jor-El, for you to spin your tale of horror.
Derision and disbelief are not new to men of science. For centuries, they have combated the skepticism you display.
Give us facts.
Briefly, gentlemen, it is this. The sun is gradually drawing our planet into its orbit. Soon, the gravitational pull will be so strong that Krypton will be unable to withstand the strain. When that moment occurs, our world will shatter into millions of fiery fragments. Nothing can survive such a catastrophe.
Perhaps he is right. We must do something. I believe we should give him the benefit of the doubt. We cannot risk such peril.
Gentlemen.
Assuming for a moment that what you say is true, how can we avoid this disaster?
It cannot be avoided. It is a natural evolution of nature, a force that even we supermen are...